Hang on, hang on. Okay, now you're ready.
Welcome. We come in peace. Okay. Welcome to the 12 o'clock session of the.
You have to stay here when I die.
Expo. Continue to fight for what we want to assist us and to offer his very specific perspective on self-confidence. Two program notes, if you have a cell phone, a lightsaber, or anything like that, please turn it off for the next hour and a half. And also, if you are looking to get a copy of this session, it will be available downstairs at some point in the main lobby where there are some of these sort of things. Okay? And Juan has an extensive background, there's a list of folks that are here. I went out to ask him, like, what did you talk about, or how I should introduce him. He said he just do it at the moment. So I think he's very capable of introducing himself. And thank you.
Thank you. So, I didn't read the program guide, okay, to what I have to talk about today. They make these things up, you know, a month or so, you know, in advance. So if you have anything in there that I want me to cover, definitely let me know if I don't cover it. So, let's see here. Talk about source energy. Source energy is always with you, unless you're a clone body. Okay, we talked about that just briefly. In 2012, December 21st, somehow the buzzword got out about the Mayan calendar, the end of days, we'll say, typically. The remote viewers couldn't see past that. And so that was a point to where everybody was abducted, except for maybe 10% of the population. So people left, clones came back in their place. So we'll talk about clones here so you get an idea of what I'm talking about. How many of you out there, and you can just raise your hand, have went into a store, given the cashier change, didn't know how to give change back to you? Okay? So that's a clone. Okay? Clones bad? No, not necessarily. They have a real short memory time, maybe a couple of weeks. At least that was what it was back then, say a year ago, okay? They don't know how to relate here, but they are very nice workers. A lot of times they're very pleasant to deal with. Just like your typical android type of person, they bleed, everything else. They're the replica of the human that was abducted around December. Okay, the abductions probably started after September of 2012 and kind of moved forward to the end of the year. How many people have went to a parking lot and seeing a bunch of cars? You go to the stores, maybe wherever you're going, like a shopping mall, and there's no people in the stores walking around. Okay? Raise a hand, anybody have seen that experience? Okay? So where do those people go? Do they happen to leave their car parked there and went to Denny's or someplace, you know, 5 blocks away? No, they all got abducted. The humans drove the cars there, got zapped up someplace to the Beyondo. And then either they were altered, a new clone replica came in, take their place at some point. And so what happened this year was the same basic thing was going on. Somehow they maybe copy and pasted the timelines so that this would happen again. It wasn't quite as bad, but it was still another thing. So what's the difference between a human and a clone? Okay, a human has spirit consciousness, has energy in their bodies, from source energy, and a clone doesn't have that. They run on programs. So they're very limited. I would say, let's see here. I'll just use the word most, okay? It could be more than most, but most is pretty good. Most of the people in governments are cloned out. It's been happening for years and years. I saw a clone factory a long, long time ago, seeing these people, you know, that we all know about, from probably about the early 60s, the current, in a room, and they had all the clone bodies like on a coat rack. And you push a button and you say, oh, okay, this person's gonna now move their right arm. So you see like 20 of these dressed clone replicas, right? Push a button, all their arms go up, okay? You want them to smile, another button, they smile. And so remember, what happens is that you're out of time here. You're on, off, on, off, on, off, on, off. So you can say, well, how can that happen? How can somebody be taken out, a new clone put in, and I don't see that? Well, since the aliens control time, and you live in a time-based reality, where are you when you're turned off? Where are you when you're not here? Nobody has that answer, because the aliens are in control of time. They're in control of your consciousness. So you think that you're here continuously, and you're not. You're being turned off and on, off and on, off and on. People talk about alien ships. They go, you know, I've seen, you know, maybe you've seen a silver ship someplace floating up in the sky or something. Well, most of the sightings that people have where they actually see a ship, that's a government, military, reverse-engineered spaceship. Okay, so people talk about UFOs in that agenda, like, oh, we saw the sighting over here, and I saw one over there. Most of those are government, I'd say 90% of them. Now, what you don't see are the ones that are up in the clouds over your head, the ship clouds. Those are flat-bottom clouds. So how many here have seen flat-bottom clouds? Okay, that's alien ships. Okay, why is the cloud flat-bottom? Because that's where the ships are. So the ship is up there. We can't physically see it, but the clouds somehow, you know, move around the ship, and they're detected that way. What are those ships doing to you? Well, we know about chemtrails, right? So that's another agenda completely, but maybe the ships are worse than the chemtrails. Okay, they're giving you mind control transmissions. So I have some free claimings on my website. Just go to creationlightship.com. It's very simple on the right side. Look for the free clearings, and they have all alien clearings there that I have that are free. I have other ones too, but I have one that can take the head connectors off of you, which they connect to your head. I have one which is the satellite clearing, and I put up three new ones. What I'll do is a sample right here for the holographic alien reality one. So what they can do is they can change your reality instantly and create like a brand new movie set for you. And that would be created on a timeline. So first talk about timelines. So timelines are what you're living on. So if you have any type of condition happening to you, a sore throat, maybe you have a pain in your body, an emotional situation, you are probably living on maybe 1,000 timelines of that. So at first you don't know what's going on. Maybe you trip and fall, you hurt yourself. Then the aliens see the energy from you being emitted. So you have emotional energy, right? We live with that. And then we have pain energy. And those are the two basic energies, right, that we have. You know, we have traumas, but that could be under emotions too. So we emit this energy out of us, and they live on that. So all of a sudden you hurt yourself somehow. Maybe you trip and fall, skin your knee or whatever. You're in pain, and you get upset because you did it, blaming yourself or somebody else because you tripped over something. Whatever it is, it's still emotional stuff. So right away, they put you on emotional timelines of that. So now you're on the pain timeline of hurting your knee. So now you're replicated in a reality. Remember, the New Age movement talks about that you're a multidimensional being. That's all darkness. Darkness energy has controlled everything. So now you're a multidimensional being living on multidimensional timelines, controlled by aliens. Now, source energy only has one life in the present moment. There's only one, we'll say, using the word timeline. There's only one timeline when you're in the moment. You're not a multidimensional being. You're not all over the map. But they replicate you, the aliens do, so they can get more energy off of you. So they copy and paste you. And now you're trying to get well here, right? So you're here on one timeline only, and they're bleeding through and bringing into you, deja vu, we'll call it, okay, all these other timelines with your physical pain and traumas, and you can't get well because all of a sudden you're out there and you're not healing yourself on the other timelines. So how do you heal yourself? Your only power that you have, never outside of yourself, your only power is your spirit inside of you. I use the word spirit. If you want to use soul, you can interchange it, but I use the word spirit. That's in your heart center. That's where you live. That's your only connection to source energy, never outside of yourself. So right away, when I start talking, you might think, gee, what about the person over here who does these angel readings, and these one channels are Angel Michael, this one's Raphael, this one's that. That's all darkness energy. It's mind energy. So you have two energies. You have source energy, which the aliens took you away from, because you're not in your heart. And all the other energies are dark side energies created, which I call the light of the darkness. Yes?
Clones don't have a soul or a spirit.
No, they don't.
So how do they get that energy?
I can do that for them. I have it on my website too. Okay? So I have two clearings. I have one which is aliens into light, and I have one that's clones into light. So if you find that your one of your family members or your boss or whatever is acting different, you know, maybe one of your employees, if you're in a business, and you say, gee, why can't you give change for a $20 bill? It's real simple. You just do this here, and they go, I don't know what money is, you know. I'm sorry. Teach me, right? So you go, uh-oh, what's wrong with this person? They did it last week. Now they're not doing it now. Well, it's just a replica of them. So you can bring in a spirit. I'll do that here for people. You can bring in a spirit into the body like you have, the ones that are not cloned, okay? And that can also bring in the energy into their body to make the body of light also. You actually have two spirits in your body. You have one of your body energy, which is source energy, creation energy, and then you have one which is the spirit. And your spirit does nothing really for you. It's just here for the ride. It's trying to come forward, in a sense, to put its energy into your creations. Okay? It can, in a sense, guide you a little bit. Okay? But typically, you can't ask it for favors. It doesn't know.
How would you define spirit?
A spirit is source energy, which is peace. Okay, so source energy is strictly peace energy. I'll be doing a mind to heart drop so you can actually feel peace energy. Yes?
Can a clone tell if it's a clone?
Can a clone tell if it's a clone? No. As a program, it doesn't know. And what's out of that program? It's like your computer. You know, you have, like, let's just say you have a Macintosh and you have, a PC, right? To a certain extent, they're kind of interchangeable with some programs, right? But you can't really use one for the other because they're different things, but they're both computers. Yes?
Yeah, how are human beings selected?
Well, if you notice, a person mentioned this, and I think it's probably correct, okay, first of all, the aliens want to get people that are really, really large. Okay, so if you are raising cattle, right, you want to have a really large cow to butcher, right? You want a thin one. So if you notice that most of the people now, for whatever reason, maybe drinking soft drinks or whatever, are getting larger here. Okay? So if you just pull yourself out of everything else, hey, maybe it's juicier, So they're looking for larger people. So how do they select you? How do they select you? So let's say that you went to church all the time and you become prey. Okay, remember, you go to church, hypothetically, and you're asking an alien god. I'm not talking about Jesus. But they have fabricated the Jesus, which is the light of the darkness, which are in all the churches. Okay, so now you're praying outside of yourself to ask for a favor, right? Don't you in church? Oh, God, help me, right? And you're asking a favor from an alien to help you out. So now you're hooked up. Right? You're a fish. You saw the bait on the hook, and you got hooked up. So who are they going to take? All the ones that are hooked up.
So if you're really self-determined, you're...
Heart-centered. You have to be heart-centered. Yeah. Okay. I'll do that for you right now, okay? Now, anything that you use in the mind energy, when you think of something, you're in darkness, okay? Why? Because they control that. They control your thoughts. Remember, you have these energies from the alien ships up there giving you mind control transmissions, and you're acting according to that. I'll talk a little bit more right now before I do the mind to heart drop for you and show you what's happening. Your only Okay, a human, okay? A human is only here a few hours, we'll say, out of the month. So I want you all to think back of the time that you woke up one day and you go, man, I got my shit together. I'm going to do this. I got all these plans. I wrote them all down. I'm going to do this in the next week. Wake up the next day and you look at it and you go, it looks kind of weird to me. I can't do all this stuff. So that one day out of the month, when you really feel energized, you're actually physically here. And you're energizing your skeleton, which allows them to now bring in their clone replicas of you that get switched out every 10 minutes. So we're talking about humans. I'll show you an example up here with people. Okay? So you are a clone replica of yourself every 10 minutes, and every 10 minutes, and 10 minutes is what seems to work. It's not 11, or it's not 9, it's 10 for some reason. So every 10 minutes, they change your consciousness. So, and you're being turned off and on and off and on. So for 10 minutes, you are owned by one particular alien race. Now in the process, they have to fabricate all your surroundings, because you're living in a holographic reality, okay? They have to change the way you look, make you so you look like the last cloned replica of you, make your clothing, fix up your hair, okay? And change your body weight, your body height, or whatever. They try to replicate you. Now, if you get an alien race where maybe they have a beginner making the hologram and doing things to you, you may feel goofy for a while, but after 10 minutes, it goes away. Everybody feel like you just don't feel right sometimes? And then 10 minutes, it goes away? Right? You go, what happened? You know, I'm like in a fog in the days. Well, you probably had somebody that didn't really know how to control you too well, and they couldn't really fabricate the hologram around you, and they're just, you know, maybe just a beginner, you know, an apprentice who was working with you. So what do? They take you and they timeshare you. So, did I lose anybody yet? Here, back there. I'm in the moment. I'm telling you what's happening in reality. Okay.
So have you switched since you've been up there, since you've been talking for longer than 10 minutes?
No, I don't switch. I'm in source energy only. And I don't deal with your time-based reality. So I'm in the moment. I'm in the true moment of source. So you have, let me draw a little picture here. So where you people are, you're being turned off and on, off and on, and off and on. I don't do that. That's why I can talk to you about what's happening. Now, you heard spiritual gurus and teachers talk about being in the moment, right? Well, they're bringing you into the moment of time where time is turned off. So you're being in the now where time is off. I'll show you the difference. Ready? So I'm going to turn you off right now. So, and I'll take you to the off state, right? So I'll count to five to do that. I can set my fingers, but I want you to feel it changing. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Now you're turned off. And when you're turned off in the time-based reality, nothing can really cord you. Look around you. Do you feel like you're in oneness with things around you? Or do you feel like you're separate? You should feel separate. Okay? Now, I'll bring you to where I am. That's not in time. Time does not exist in source energy. Okay? Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There. Now you're in source energy. You're out of the loop. You're out of the alien control. How's it feel?
I feel different.
Different?
No, I don't feel any different.
Okay.
10 seconds.
Okay. Anybody else? Anybody feel a change? Okay.
I want to.
Okay. See what that is. Anyway. So anyway, and sometimes this can be normal. So don't feel like you're stranger. Okay. So in source energy, there's no thoughts. Okay. Since you're all turned off, can you think right now? Can you think? No. Okay. So now you go out the door out here, and you see the next, we'll just say hypothetically, the next room, you have an angel, person channeling angels, and channeling Archangel Michael and Jesus and whatever, and you got a whole panel up there of all these intuitive psychics. What are they getting? It's not a source energy. But you think because they got this card in front of them that they're channeling Archangel Michael, and it's giving good messages out to the audience, right? They're channeling darkness. Source energy has no thought. You understand that? Okay. So, I'm not really popular, too popular at all these expos that I go to, because everybody out there is completely contrary to what I'm talking about. They're locked into alien energies. And geez, they say, you know, if I were to say, you're channeling an angel, they don't exist. They do exist in darkness. They go, oh, geez, you know, it's, you know. So that's where I come from. I'm from source energy. I don't have to deal with this crap, you know. You guys are stuck here because the aliens gave you mind programs. They gave you DNA, and the DNA is what you activate. So think of a baby, right? We've all seen babies, correct? And at some point, the baby switches over from being in source energy into mind control. Now, before they're out of source energy, they just vibrate. You see light around them, okay? And so then when they get into mind energy, the energy drops off. And then they're now tagged and put into alien agenda. Yes?
So you said that if you're being able to be switched on and off, you don't have that.
Yeah.
So is that something that you're born with, or is that something that you learn over time?
You can't learn it. Yeah.
But I'm getting switched on and off.
You're here.
Is that a possibility for me?
No.
And so you came here and you don't have to worry about that at all.
Right.
That's awesome.
Yeah. I'm an alien to the aliens.
What's that?
I'm an alien to the aliens.
You're an alien to the aliens. And
yeah.
Why are you? Because you're talking about the aliens gave us this in our DNA. You also have DNA.
Yeah, but it's turned off.
Just by you saying it's turned off doesn't let me, like, how do we know that? I guess is what I'm asking. How are you born with being able to not be controlled, and how are we just completely subjected to it?
Okay. Good question. What people do is cord people, right?
What's that?
People energetically cord people. And you know what that's like when you cord somebody? You pull energy off them? Okay. All of you try to cord me.
I don't know how to do that.
Try to project an energy from your mind, which is cording, right, to me. You can't. No.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You can't cord light. So I'm a light being. It's impossible. When you come into my energy field, trying to attach to my face, my throat, or whatever you want to try to cord, all you're going to be getting is light back to you, peace energy.
So you're a light being.
Yeah.
That incarnated.
Yeah.
So there are.
It sucks.
There are other light beings on this planet.
No,
as well.
No.
Oh, you're the only one out of 7 billion+ that is.
There was five here, and one was activated. No, there was five here. One was doing the mission, which is Princess Diana. Mm-hmm. Darkseid killed her, but she's known for humanitarian issues and things. The other ones that came here are not activated because the darkness took them over. They got into mind energy.
And you can't assist them in any way. You know who they are or where?
No. I don't even tune into them. No. It's meaningless to me.
Why?
It doesn't matter. At ascension time, they'll be out of here. So, let's do I'll do the mind to heart drop, okay? And then I'll have to take you out of that because you won't know what I'm talking about. Remember, source energy has no communication for words. Okay? Ready? How's the battery doing? Is it looking good? Okay. So I'm going to command your spirit, which you, this you have to do yourself also, but I'm doing it for you. So you have to command it out loud to take your thoughts from your head and go to your heart center, which is where your spirit resides. Why it's going to your heart, I have no clue. Okay, that's just where it is. Could have been, you know, why didn't they pick your left shoulder or something, you know, or elbow, but it goes to the heart. So here we go. Dropping down. So commanding your spirit to do this for you, and I'll just count from 10 to 1. I'm going to stop at 5 and put your thoughts in your throat so you can actually feel it. So 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. Stop there. Don't think. Feel kind of strange? Okay. So 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. There, now you're in your heart center. No thoughts, you're at peace. How do you feel? Feel good? So that should be taught in first grade. Okay? So what do you do when you meditate? People meditate in here. A lot of people probably meditate. That's one of the things that people do. What do? You go in the beyondo, right? Using mind energy, darkness energy, alien energies, to think about where you're going through this nice, wonderful guided meditation, taking you up and down someplace in the beyondo, and your spirit's gone. It wants to get the hell out of here, so it's gone. It's out, okay? Who's protecting your body? Who's coming into you? What aliens are coming into your body? What shapeshifters, okay? What emotional bodies are coming into you? Because your body's a host. So why meditate? You can do the mind of heart drop 15 seconds here in your heart and you can function. Get out of your heart, go back in it again. Be in source energy. In source energy, it's very hard for the aliens to do anything with you because you're in source energy. You're off the timeline. So you understand timelines? Did I cover that enough about parallel lives? A parallel life is a timeline, okay? So when you're on their timelines, they're controlling you. When you're in source energy in the now, with your spirit, then they have a hard time getting you. I can't guarantee that they're not going to get you, but it's very hard because you're not on their timeline. So then you're in the now. When you're into the mind of heart drop, then you're in the now. Then you're in source energy, your own source energy. Because you're created from source energy. It never leaves you unless you kick it out of your body, take drugs or something, then you're out. Yes? Why do they want you to have timelines? Well, they get more mileage out of you. If you hurt yourself on one timeline and they can replicate you into 1,000 of them, man, they got a good feeding station. Make sense to all of you? Yes? They live off energy, okay? What they don't have is a spirit, so they're trying to steal your spirit also, okay?
Why wouldn't they have a spirit?
Because source, okay, you have two energies. You have the energies of light, and then you have the other energy, which is in a whole different realm, whole different consciousness. Nothing's wrong with it, okay? That doesn't have a spirit, okay? So let's say you have red people here, right, and you have green people here, and they're both living lives, right? Well, that's fine. Nothing's wrong with a different energy source, right, a different colored energy. But when one tries to invade the other to take it over, that's where the problem occurs, okay? And so we're dealing with an agenda out there of aliens who want to take over humans. Oh, yeah. A lot of them could have spirits, but they may have switched over to darkness.
It seems that if they constantly have light and they have darkness, the light would make them sick because they're only into evil.
Yeah, well, it's not that they're into evil, but they may not know what light is. How many of you went to church? Everybody probably in here, right? Okay, well, you turned into darkness by going to church. You prayed to something outside of yourself and got hooked up. You have a spirit, right? It's got the wrong teachings. What's Jesus' teaching? Why did Jesus come here? He came here to take away your sins, so to speak, right? Is that what you were taught, right? Now, what does that mean 2,000 years ago? The people were contaminated with DNA by thinking ascension time was here 2,000 years ago. He came for ascension, which means that he came to take people off the planets to get them released from the alien mind control. So he did an emotional body clearing on them, right? Remember, 2,000 years ago, you didn't have TV and radio and newspapers, right? Maybe you had newspapers or something like that, but you know, all you had is little small groups of people, right? So you're not inundated with all the stuff that we have now. It was much, very, very much simpler to do stuff back then. So he came here and he worked with the people only who were living, okay, at that time for ascension. Take away the mind control from the aliens. When he died, when he left here, the healings that he did not continue on for 2,000 years. That's all just a false information for you to go thinking Jesus is going to appear. They created the false Jesus, the light of the darkness Jesus, brought in all the angels and stuff that people are using. And they do give information that they can do healings. The dark can heal you quicker than the light can. Anybody have okay, I'll repeat that. The darkness can heal you faster than the light. Now, anybody know why?
Because they created the illnesses and maladies.
Yeah, they created it for you. Right? The light only works in the moment. How does the light heal you? The light looks at you in the moment, sees your problem, and releases it, gives you peace. Okay? So one little piece of you is healed. Okay? Next, if you need some more healing, which you have to request it, because the light doesn't continuously work on you. Has no agenda. Okay? So then you say, oh, I need some more help here. Okay? Then your spirit can work with you and try to heal that. And again and again and again. Nothing's outside of yourself but darkness. So be very suspicious when you find out that. We only lost a few people here. That's pretty good. Yes? What's that again?
Are the inner voices we hear for guidance our spirit, and how do we know?
You don't always know. Your spirit can possibly talk to you. Okay, when I did the mind to heart drop, there's silence, right? You're with your spirit. Let's do it again here, because you're out of your hearts now, and you have to be out of your heart center for you to hear me. Because if you're in your heart center, you're not going to understand vocabulary. Okay, doesn't exist. So here we go, drop it into your heart again. So I'll just do it. There, now you're in your heart center. Now, ask your spirit for guidance, see if you have any information coming to you. Remember, just peace energy. Source energy is peace energy. So you may get something, you may not. How's that feel? Anybody have any communications going on? Want to raise your hand if you have communications? Okay, out of this whole room, I see no hands. Oh, we got communication. Okay? Yes, a question?
I was just listening to you about Christ. For me, it's wholeness, light, that's what brings healing. Darkness for me does not bring healing for me.
Okay, so what? Okay, yeah, well, okay, so I guess the question is, I'm not completely getting it, but see, if you go to a practitioner, okay, let's talk about Reiki. How many here are Reiki students, have Reiki practitioners? Okay, here we go, ready? So what are you using when you use Reiki energy?
Light.
Using light? What kind of light?
Like golden light coming okay. To my
okay, so you're bringing in something outside of yourself, though.
It's coming through my chakra.
Yeah.
It's coming through my hand. I can see that.
Okay, but what you're doing is you're bringing an alien energy in. See, with Reiki, you have symbols, right? Mm-hmm. They teach you symbols to use, and you draw symbols, and you bring in an energy from outside of yourself, which is not source energy. Remember, I said darkness can heal, okay? So you're bringing in an alien energy that has the agenda of doing a healing, okay? And it can work. I'm not saying that the darkness can't heal, but you're still using mind energy because you were taught this, okay? And so that's what Reiki does, is it brings in that energy from mind, and all mind energy is darkness because it's not source energy. It's a darkness energy in mass consciousness, collective consciousness, whatever word you want to use there, and that energy can heal people because it knows the problem that you're dealing with.
But anyhow, I heal people. I don't know.
Yeah. And it could work fine. Just that, what are they being hooked up to? What are those symbols? How are they being used to hook up people? Okay? Nobody knows because you don't know. Yes?
Well, you said it's dark energy that's healing. Why cannot source the fountain?
I can. Are you going to your heart to ask for healings?
Well, like she said she was channeling. Maybe she's channeling source energy.
You can't channel source energy.
Why not?
You already have it with you. That's outside of yourself.
Well,
anything outside of yourself, you cannot channel source energy. Okay? If you went to source energy right now, if you said, oh, I see source energy out there, what would it think of you? It would see all your DNA, all the darkness in you, you'd be terminated. Zap.
In 2021, December, I get rain. I was in Cairo, and I get rain, like rainbow rain on my body. What is
wrong? I don't know. You see, you cannot connect to source energy. You already have it. Now, the light of the darkness will tell you that it's out there, and you can go to source energy. Remember, what I'm doing here, you all have your own belief systems, okay? And it's almost impossible to change your belief system because it's worked for you for your whole life. You're in the soup, and the soup tastes good, and it works, okay? And I'm just trying to show you a way that you know, I'm trying to tell you a way using your languaging, which is hard to do, to communicate to you about the darkness and what you're involved with because you're still here. So what I could say is you were probably here genetically, right, with your ancestors when Jesus walked the earth, okay? But for some reason, they didn't catch on and the darkness got them. And at that ascension point, you didn't leave here. So you've been stuck here for the last 2,000 years. Okay? Now, how many prior ascensions have you missed? Remember, the dark side can change time. So I guess the question now would be, what is ascension, right?
Yeah.
You've heard about it. It's been a buzzword for a long time. A lot of people, you talk about ascension, they go, oh, I already know what that is. I heard that last 10 years, and I'm inundated with ascension, right? You think good thoughts, you're a nice person, and you're waiting to be taken off planet, and maybe the aliens will come and grab you and take you out of here. So here's what ascension is. At ascension time, because this planet is controlled by darkness energies, aliens, okay, giving you mind control transmissions, okay, you all understand that, I hope, I'm trying to drive it in so you understand it, okay. At ascension time, the light says, well, it's time to leave, turns the main power switch off. There's no more light. Everything connected to light is no longer on. And the light collects its creations, okay? Now, if there's no light and nothing exists, then naturally the darkness cannot attach to you, which you do have light in your body, and you are, you know, you do have light, correct? Because you're created from light. Darkness can't see you, and it falls away. The leeches get off of you, okay? And the light takes you. And then at some point, talking in linear time here, that power switch is turned back on again. Now everything has to be recreated. So everything now is recreated. And then you go out and you live in light again and you do what you want to do. Free choice, free will. But no thought. Okay? So so the last time the ascension happened, the dark side saw the light getting turned off, abducted almost everybody, took him to another parallel life, right? Maybe they just rolled the film back a few hours or whatever, second, and you're not living your life like you normally would. They create all these holograms, right? And you're living it. And then we're just waiting for the light to get turned back on again. So the light gets turned back on. The planet now is materialized of light. This planet does have light in it, even though it's abducted by the aliens, okay? Just like you people are, okay? And the aliens out here in the beyond will go, oh, the Earth is turned on again. We got light. Well, we'll just do to take the old bus trip and the railroad tracks, put them over here, right? And now you're transported back to the Earth here. You didn't know the difference. So that's ascension. You can't prepare for it. You can do clearings to get rid of the darkness out of you, which is what I'm here to help you with, okay? But you don't know when it's going to be. Everything's instant. No, darkness energy doesn't have spirit energy with it.
Because whenever you say it's light energy or dark energy, I assume we're all thinking, well, then it's evil energy everywhere that's not trying to get me. But I don't think that's the case.
Well, the dark energy is mind controlling you. Okay. No.
But
so
is that controlling me with malice? Or
it's controlling you. It's controlling you. It's taking you out of source energy. Agenda. Is there agenda? Yes, there's always an agenda.
So is that agenda evil or good?
I don't deal with evil and good. It's just an agenda. Okay? Is it the agenda could be for you to eat 10 bars of chocolate every day. Is that good or is that bad?
Probably bad.
Yeah, but somebody else may love eating that. You know, but you could say it's bad, right? Source energy doesn't judge. So initially you were put down on this planet here. When the aliens created you, okay, let me go back further. So we'll just say the aliens were created by source energy. So they have a spirit and a body, right? Just like you have. And somehow they got connected, enticed to go into darkness to have thoughts. They got imprinted with mind energy. Now they're out of their jurisdiction of source energy, right? And now you're living in the jurisdiction of mind energy, okay? And so now you're trying to control things, okay? It's like this expo here, hypothetically. Everybody is out there who has a booth trying to get your $5 out of your pocket or something, right?
Amen.
Right? Okay, yeah, look at reality here, right? They're here. They're not really here. They're here to give you some advice or to help you some way, but they're all here to make some money, right? That's the dark side agenda. In source energy, that wouldn't exist. Everything is freely given. Okay? Right? Okay. So, I don't know what I was talking about before. I'm in the moment, but did that answer your question? Oh, okay, okay. Oh, yeah. So you were created by the aliens. You got your DNA stripped out of you. That would help you. That would be a better spirit connection for you, in a sense, okay? And they gave you all this other tons of DNA, which collects the thoughts of your ancestors. So you got a really gigantic hard drive, right? Like I said earlier, the babies aren't connected to that hard drive yet, okay? They didn't know yes and no, stop, go yet, okay? And once they get hooked up into that energy, all of a sudden, they're controlled by the aliens, by the mind energy. And so, were the aliens good to bring you down here? Well, possibly. And then maybe the darkness took you over. Okay? And so all of you out here, since you're all from a different race, different skin color, different heights, you know, different parts of this planet, hypothetically, initially, but so you're all, you know, a mixed culture here. But your DNA that they gave you stores your past genetic codings, which is what they rely on. They want you to live in your past. So your past reality, right, what does it do for you? If you get in fear with something, that's from your past, right? That past now is projected. Remember, you're living that timeline. Let's just say that you burn your finger, right? Somehow you're cooking or just say you pinch yourself right now hard enough and it hurts, right? Well, you're going to bring back a past reality of hurting yourself. You're on that timeline, say a burn in your finger, right? Now you're living in the past, you have all the pain, That now produces a current timeline from the now that you're in into the future, and now you're living in a future timeline. And you're creating that timeline in the future of all this current event. So let's say that you go to the doctor, and you feel fine, but you have a little pain, right? And you go to the doctor, and the doctor goes, oh, man, that looks like cancer. Right away, by him telling you that, he puts you onto a cancer timeline. Thousands of them. You may not even have cancer, okay? But he told you that. You believed his thought. He imprinted you. And all of a sudden, now you're on 1,000 timelines, worrying about cancer, bringing that energy right to you to manifest into your body as cancer. You awakened it. So the aliens gave you that wonderful thing of your DNA to have all the stored memories of you to get activated to bring you into your future reality of an experience. So the New Agers talk about your thoughts, right, can be used to create your reality, right? Different ways of saying that, right? Yeah, it's true. Darkness does that. The source energy doesn't exist. Darkness, it works perfect. That's the dark side energies. But your thoughts control your reality. Yes?
Is that what the Gnostics
talk
about, the
Archons? I don't know nothing about that.
Dark parasites?
Dark parasites, yeah. Yeah, that's the alien stuff. In fact, I'll, yes, this lady. Okay, want to speak louder?
Why are so many humans incarnated on the planet? Why is increasing the population increasing in every continent in a way that isn't...
Food? Alien food?
Why are we increasing?
Yeah.
Population is
because we're having too many children.
Yeah.
Because we don't take responsibility for ourselves.
I know.
But it's a mind control program.
Why is that?
Energetic food or physical food. Yeah, we're all the missing people. All the missing people are probably out in Cannes someplace. You know, they're already abducted. So that's you're looking at mind control programs. Okay. Yeah, it's a mind control program. It's all mind control programs for people.
But also in religion, in general, you want to have as more people to come to your church, if possible, to give you money. It's not just the aliens. It's also our own institutions that we have created through all the different religious factors.
It's all the same stuff. Okay. Same common denominator. Yes? Clones are here. The clones are here. You got it. The clones are here. Maybe they can change your program so they don't need to eat much. It's an artificial intelligent body. It's an alien. It's like you see on TV or movies. Well, you know, how many of you seen movies where they have clones, where they have robots walking around and stuff. It's been out for, 20, 30 years. Get a clue. What you're seeing in those movies is fact. A lot of those movies, those people are probably actually bilocated to that planet where you're seeing these scenes. They may not know that, but they're seeing these scenes. They film it, and they bring it back into a movie. That's getting a little far out. You'd think it's done on a movie set, you know? This gentleman here.
It's always been.
Yeah.
So actually, my reason for being here is wanting to be more connected with that source energy, and because most of this other stuff seems to be
woo-woo,
extraneous.
Yeah, it is. Anything outside of yourself is not source energy. So if you tap into it, You have to really understand that you have it with you completely. You all have it if you're not a clone.
So just by
but you can't use your mind to get to it.
Right. But by totally being in the moment with that source energy, we actually all become one. Isn't that
true? You're not in oneness, no. You're separate.
You're separate?
But yeah. Source energy never created oneness. You are in the energy of source energy, and you're separate as a creation from source energy, but you're still in source energy. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. All right.
So that's why I dropped into your heart, so you could feel that.
All right, yeah.
That's the whole thing. And then you can manifest. Okay, so what happens is, let's say that you're working in a job, okay? And we'll say that you're a computer programmer, right? So now you're using, you get to your work, and all of a sudden, your boss says, hey, you got to do this job here. You have to make this program. And you go, okay, well, now you're in mind energy, right? Because now you got this thing, because it came here, and you're in mind energy. And you start playing with your computer, and you're using all your talents, and all of a sudden, without you knowing it, you shift from mind to source. It's an automatic shift. You don't realize it, okay? And now you're involved with source energy, which has all the information that you ever need, okay? And time stops for you. The clock is still going, right? And you're doing your stuff. And all of a sudden, you might feel a little hungry. Maybe you don't. Or you look at your clock all of a sudden, and you go, geez, I started this at 1 o'clock, and it's 4 o'clock now. What happened? You have all this work done. You're in source energy. You're working with your spirit and source energy at that time. Now, you get in there, and you look at what you did, and you go, uh-oh, now I don't like what I did. Okay. Now you're back into mind energy, and you're trying to try to change your creative flow into something else. And that's okay, too. But then you're back into mind. So when time stops for you, then you're in the now, in source energy. And the darkness cannot control you when you're in that creative moment.
Does that allow you to be more creative when you're in source?
Oh, of course. Of course. Everything's available to you.
So wouldn't birth then, a child being born, because that's when humans experience that source energy, doesn't that offer an opportunity to grow?
The whole system's backwards here. When you're first born, you're in source energy. You can't do anything about it, right? You have to learn how to live here. See, the first couple years, now you're learning, and now you're in darkness. And then as you get older, you try to get back into source energy, but you have so many mind control programs put on you, it's hard. How much time do we have left? I don't know about how much time do we have left?
35 minutes.
Okay, let's do some decloning. Guys, ready?
Yes.
Who wants to be a volunteer?
Okay,
come on up here. And maybe I'll have you stand over here. So remember, I mentioned before that every 10 minutes you're a different person. Okay? And the aliens, we can get a couple more. There we go. Go ahead.
On this side or just on?
Yeah, over here.
Over there.
I'll just scoot over a little bit. Now, what I want all of you out there in the audience to do is to watch these people. Okay. Now, what will typically happen is, since they change out every 10 minutes, I'm going to change them out every second or two. Now, I want you to watch them. Their body will jerk, typically. It'll shift, may get higher, taller, may get shorter. The clothing might shift on their body a little bit, because remember, the alien race that I stopped from controlling you now has to go to the next alien race to recreate you, a new hologram, okay? Do people understand that?
I'm trying.
Okay. Okay, here we go. And watch your skin color, too, and watch the energy around their bodies, and then I'll make them real. So you're going to be real now. You ready? So, here we go. Okay, first clone out, second out, third out, fourth out, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, how do they look? Do you see any changes?
Yeah.
Okay? What do you guys feel? You feel your body getting warmer? Not yet. Okay? So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. How are you feeling?
Same.
The same. What's that?
Heavy pulse.
Heavy pulse? Okay. Palms. Sweaty palms? Heavy. Okay.
Where are all my other...
Where are they going?
Yes. I mean, it sounds like I have a whole football team of myself somewhere else.
Yeah. They're probably being terminated.
They're being terminated?
Yep.
That's mean.
Here we go. They're going into light, so they're being taken away from darkness, okay? So you got a lot of you in light right now. You don't know it, but they're there. So here we go. So I'll start again. What are we at, like 40 right now? Are we at 40 or 30?
30.
30, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. Is that right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 60. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 70. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 80. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 90. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 100. 1, there, let's try this now. Coming in to be human. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There.
I could feel like an elevation.
Okay.
My left leg is tingling.
Left leg's tingling. It's hurting before. Okay, yeah. Remember, the clones bring you your problems, okay? Now, how do these people look out there? Does it look like they're in a movie set, like they're in a fishbowl? Look at each other now. You guys look real? How do they look?
Do we look real?
They look like human beings, man, on this planet. It's the diversity, it's awesome. But, I mean, as far as, like, do they look alien?
No. Do they look like they're in a different energy field? Does it look like you have a piece of glass in front of you, and they're now on the movie set?
They look like being a different energy field.
A different energy field, right? Uh-huh. Okay. But look at each other. You're going to see a different energy in yourselves. Okay. How about the next? Okay, you can sit down now. Okay, next group. Do you want to come up? Yeah, you want to come up? Come on up. Yeah, you'll be okay. Come on up.
How many can you have up there?
As many as you want to come up.
135.
No, you can stand on there if you need to. Yeah, I just wanted people to see. Okay, here we go. And I'll stop at 10. So, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And you might feel a little energy shift in your body. Okay? So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40. Well, see if they change shapes. Just focus on one or two people. Okay? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, we had 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 60. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 70. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 80. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 90. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 100. Well, rough group. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 110. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 30. 1, 2, 3, there we go. Coming in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, there. Now you're the real you. How do you guys feel?
Tingly?
Yeah. Okay, now to how the people out here look. Do they look like they're...
Fuzzy.
Fuzzy, right? Fuzzy, like they're mannequins?
Yeah.
Right? They're in the fishbowl? You're outside of it?
Yeah.
Okay.
I feel leaning.
Leaning?
Arms are tingly?
Yeah, because you're human now. Remember, your skeleton, it holds the space, and now you have a real physical body on your skeleton. So you're feeling different. Anybody feel like they weigh a little bit less or a little bit more or a little taller, a little shorter? How's your eyesight?
Taller.
Yeah. Sharper? A lot of times your back will straighten up. Okay.
Okay, you're done.
We're done.
Thank you.
Yep. And you're going to notice that if you had, a physical condition, it might be released from you because that was in the clones. Remember, if your clone has a broken arm, then you're going to have a broken arm each time they replicate you. And once you become human, it might not attach to you. Who's next? Want another group to come up? Come on up. Remember the old days they had the, if you're older, remember the old Memorex commercial? Is this real or is this Memorex? Remember that? If you're not older, you won't know what that is, but. Okay, here we go. Another decloning process. So we're taking away your clone replicas that get changed out every 10 minutes, right? And it'll make you come in real, which normally would be once a month. Here we go. So coming out, and I'll stop at 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay. How do people feel? Do you feel a slight energy shift or anything? Okay, we'll continue on here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 30. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 40. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 50. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 60. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 70. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 80. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 90. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 100. 1, 2, coming in. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There. How's your body's feeling?
Yeah, I feel slim. More slim.
Good. Okay, anybody else want to comment?
My head feels heavier.
Head feels heavier? Uh-huh. How's your skin feel?
I feel...
Your skin should feel moisture.
Hot.
Okay.
Yeah, it's moisture.
I feel light.
Light. Okay. Uh-huh.
I feel almost light and heavy at the same time.
Okay.
Lighter, but like I'm more present.
More present. Okay.
Yeah, I feel that too.
More present. Okay. Uh-huh.
I felt like things leaving me each time.
Each time I count, remember, each time, if we slow this down, right, I say one, so that alien race, now you're gone, right? In this room, you're not here. Okay. And then the other alien race that hands a baton off of your blueprint, right, takes it, and now they put you into the Photoshop, and they recreate this whole room, this whole illusion, right? And then they bring you here, okay? And then I say two. Oh, you lost your 10 minutes, right? I'm controlling their energy. They lost their 10 minutes of time sharing, your blueprint, and now... Another alien race gets you and has to recreate you. Hopefully they're real good, okay? And then you recreated. And then when I say the next number, the same thing happens. And this is what happens. Now this you go through every 10 minutes. Now you guys can sit down if you like. So what happens is that if you're communicating with somebody and all of a sudden their eyes get kind of glossy, every 10 minutes, okay, and you don't know when that 10 minutes is going to be, and they go, you say something, and you notice that they're not home, right? Well, of course, they just came in, and then they got to find, somehow you have to go, that person has to go back in time to go back into their past memory, which they really can't find too well, to catch on to what you're talking about, and they go, oh yeah, I know what that was, yeah, you know, you've all had that experience, you know, or you talk to somebody, they don't get it, or all of a sudden they do get it. Okay, now this is even more far out. So, you know, what if you're there and you go, you know, I feel really stupid today. So then you say, okay, aliens, I need a smart clone to come into me.
Can you request that?
Yeah, why not? You are in control of what you're asking for. Remember, your thoughts control your reality. So maybe they go, oh, okay, we'll put a little more brain power in this person or something. Okay? You're still not using source energy. because you're still locked into darkness, but that can happen. Yes?
Can we declone ourselves?
Can you declone yourself? I can't teach that, no. No. Because you're still in the soup. So they're only going to allow you to know and to be able to do what they want you to do. Okay?
What is shamans in the indigenous religion people, what they do is thousands of years?
Yeah, they're still hooked into mind energy because it's passed down through the mind energy. Remember, source energy is always with you in your heart. So any kind of spiritual practice is mind energy to hook you into the alien agenda. Could the alien agenda be good? Possibly. It could be okay. You know, I don't like it, but you're still here. So that the shamans and all the spiritual practices and everything else that you've acquired, right, as far as knowledge, you're still here. Is that good? Do you guys like living here? Under the oppression, you know, and everything else that's going on? I don't think so. You know? Yes, this lady. No. Alien. Okay. Let's start over again real quick. Yes, go ahead.
You said that what you were dealing with were holograms, and you had a holographic reality here.
Yeah, it's brand new on the website. So I have, go to the website, creationlightship.com, go to the left side. There's some free clearings listed there. Just scroll down. And a little ways down, you can see a drop-down box, okay? The drop-down box has a little arrow, you know, which you click on. And I think there's maybe about 8 clearings here that are free for, it's all alien stuff. I want to have gray skies, right? You look up in the morning and you see gray skies out there, right? I'm not talking about chemtrails, I'm just talking about gray skies, okay? They look kind of similar, but I won't get into that. But the gray sky clearing can get rid of the gray skies around you. Remember, the aliens are putting, they don't want their ships to be seen, right? So what do? They get out their paintbrush and they paint over your sky, your hologram, right? And they make it gray looking. So you get on and you hear about a storm coming or something, get on that gray sky clearing, and lo and behold, I had people say within a short time, half an hour, I would say maybe 5 hours at the most, all of a sudden you're going to have blue skies. That's one of the clearings. But the new one is the holographic clearing, okay? And that's what they're doing for you, which is going to make your reality come into a hologram, another timeline. Remember, you don't want to be on timeline, so the holographic clearing can help you out. I'll do a sample of that here. So this will change the way you're thinking because they created a hologram for you to be here, okay? And you... Very interesting. Yeah, I'll tell you about... I'll keep going. Thank you. So the hologram is your creation of what they're trying to get you onto timeline. So I'll take that away. Here we go. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Boy, the gods are angry with me. In New York, I was doing timeline crashes, right? And when I was doing timeline crashes, the clouds that were in the sky became like ice cubes. Okay? And that's just how they looked. All of a sudden, you know, you have regular clouds. It's like, it looks like you're flying like over the, Alaska or something when the ice is breaking up and melting. You see, it's on my website. And that was maybe, 2.5 years ago or so. And also, like something like this here, I'm doing timeline crashes right up in the New Yorker Hotel at about 5 o'clock. And there's people everywhere. If you've ever been in New York about 5 o'clock, I mean, the streets are like, it's just... All there was is cars, taxi cabs, and people. All of a sudden, I'm doing timeline crashes, and the fire alarm goes off. Right? I didn't hear it. But all of a sudden, I look outside, and I hear the sirens. In New York, all you hear is sirens off and on. And they had like a hook and ladder out there. They got about 5 fire trucks, and they're all coming into the building. because they have to come in. They got all their garb on and their axes and all this stuff, you know, coming in, like probably 50 of them, looking for the fire. And that's what happened. I was doing timeline crashes. So it's a very interesting thing to do. What do I need to cover here? Implants. And I want to do some quick healing. So anybody have an ache or pain in their body? Or you have something that might be a problem that you think it could be an implant? Okay. So here we go. We're going to take that away. I'll count to five. One, two, three, four, five. There. I should be released from you. Now you might say, what am I doing? Well, I'm in source energy out of time. I'm taking you out of time, working on you, taking out the implant. Remember, you're still in time here, so you go, what's he doing, you know? Well, that's what I'm doing. Okay? I don't live in time. I'll do some emotional clearings here. Everybody think of an issue that you're dealing with in the past. Remember, because your past creates your current reality on a timeline, right? So think of an emotional situation, and I'll clear that. I'll do 10 of these. Ready? Think of the first one. Everybody have one? That's released from you. It's probably about 90% released. Look at it now. It should feel like somebody else's movie. Okay? Think of another one. That one's released. Okay? Next one. That's released. Next one. That's released. Next one. That's released. What, I got like four more to go or something? Next one. Released. Next one, released. Next one, released. I'll do one more. Next one, released. So now if you look at your life, all those miseries and problems and things that are haunting you, you may say, shit, life is really good right now, right? So that's why I have a whole lifetime clearing. So I got rid of what you're dealing with now. Maybe 10 major issues, but your whole life is crammed full of these. Whole lifetime emotional clearing. And I have a discount. It's $5 times your age. That's my infomercial here. I cap it off at the age of 60, and here you get a $50 discount. So I drop you down 10 years. It takes about 15 minutes to do. You do that, and you're cleared. You know, you're probably 95% cleared of your stuff that you have because you're living in your emotions. That's where you live, in your emotions. So how do you feel now with the... Feel good, okay. So I'm going to do a mental clearing. And here we go. Mental clearing. So this will just kind of like make you feel better. I'll just take out your mental body. Ready? Here we go. So I'll count to five so you can feel it leave you. One, two, three, four, and five. There. Disconnected from you now. Your body at more peace. Remember, these bodies were put into you by the Earth Spirit. Because the Earth Spirit from light knew that the aliens were trying to attack its life form. Remember, you're made from Earth elements, right? And the aliens were controlling that, so it needed to bring some invisible energetic bodies to you. And you have 108 energetic bodies that is making up you. How many of those the Earth Spirit put in, I don't know at this moment. It doesn't make any difference. But there's probably at least a dozen of them that are there to protect you from people thinking good thoughts about you, right? A psychic attack, and bad thoughts about you, and aliens coming into your reality, giving you mind control programs. So what should I cover next here? Anybody have anything that's, yes? Mind to heart drop.
Okay.
Command your spirit out loud to take your thoughts from your heart, drop it down. 15 seconds, you're there. Very, very simple.
How to bring crystal children or spirit of light, how to have children?
I don't know what to do with...
The emergency response team has determined that there's been a false alarm. We apologize for any inconvenience it may have caused you. May I have your attention, please? May I have your attention? Emergency response team has determined that there's been a false alarm. We apologize for any inconvenience this may have caused you.
Yep. Aliens didn't like it. So, yeah, I don't know much about the crystal children, you know. Remember, you know, the darkness created dimensions. So they could be bringing in another life form in here from another dimension. In source energy, there's no dimensions. Okay? It's just source energy. There's no judgment in source energy. Okay? That's why when you do the mind to heart drop, you know that you can't think and you're not in judgment because there's no judgment in source energy. It's peace. Okay? Question. Yeah. And okay, now if you start doing that, you're going to realize that you're going to get a little spacey, quote-unquote, to your friends because you're out of time. Okay? Everybody here lives in time, right? You know, I only have so long to talk here, right? I'm time controlled. So when you do the mind of heart drop more and more, you're going to realize that, yeah, I need to get a day planner. So you can keep track of this alien time-based reality because I've got to respond to it and live in it. But you can be peaceful living in it. Okay?
Is there any one particular alien race that's in charge?
No, there's lots of alien races. So. They're all doing it to you.
They're all doing it.
All the alien races that you have heard about, okay, let's just say that you're in here and you go to the MUFON meetings, right, the alien, you know, things, right, and you read about aliens and alien magazines and they talk about this race, that race, and so-and-so's channeling this and that and the other, whatever. Well, anything that you have heard about, they're in duality. The alien agenda is duality. So if you heard about them, they're in duality. Where are they on that pecking order? What's controlling them? Because they're in the same soup that you are, just that they're maybe a little bit older than you and they have more technology. You know, why didn't the aliens come here when, say, Henry Ford, right, created his automobile? Think about that. Why don't they say, you know, instead of giving you this thing that runs on fossil fuel, because remember, you got the invention from someplace, right? At some point in some time energy, right? Whenever that was, they created, you know, our standard conventional motor with pistons and runs on gasoline, right? Why didn't they say, you know, we got a better way. We don't have this thing on our spaceships, right? We have this little box here that you can put in your car and it'll make a lift off the ground and move. They didn't give it to you. They gave him the technology.
We didn't have the means to make it, even if they did.
Oh, we could have had the means. All inventions here are from aliens. Yeah, everything that you're dealing with is mind energy, the collective consciousness, and that comes from the alien agenda to teach you something so you can understand and make things. That's why I said when you're doing your own creation and you're out of time, you're getting much better results than you are when you're trying to use mind energy to figure something out. You all know that. You know, if you're a painter and you start painting and you get in that creative flow and you get done and you look at it and you go, wow, I did that, right? You all know that. You've all experienced that. You go, what happened? Can I recreate that moment? No, you can't because you're in source energy in the moment. There's no memory in source energy. It doesn't have any agenda. Doesn't tie you to the past. Doesn't create a future for you. It's only in the now. Yes?
There's a new genetic technology that I want to get your take on that we've been exploring that basically takes a photograph of yourself as a baby, as a child when you're in the perfection state, uses lasers and other sensors to convert the photograph into waveform DNA, where it does like a holographic torsion kind of
okay.
Print into a sound that's kind of like static. That's your DNA print in a holographic audio form. That supposedly you listen to your DNA as a child, and it reprograms yourself to be more towards perfection or more less DNA damage.
I think that could probably
brain damage. And
yeah, I would think that could possibly work because your DNA is time triggered.
Right.
Okay. Remember, you're living in a time-based reality, so what's going on with you is all these time... Okay, I'll take out some implants, okay? And I'll take out an implant that is going to go off in you in 5 minutes. And I want to see how you feel. Ready?
Yes.
There. How do you feel?
Good.
Feel different?
Something left?
Yeah, and so what you have here, this so you know, this is the same thing as you're asking. So you're living in a time-based reality, and each moment, each second in time is bringing forth an experience for you to experience, good or bad, okay? Remember, your time-based reality is, are you going to stand up and trip? Okay, you're on that timeline possibly of tripping and hurting yourself, right? You don't know that. Right now, you're sitting down. But that timeline that you're on can cause a problem for you in the future. So you want to get rid of the DNA. That's what Jesus was doing, is taking out your DNA to purify it so you're not controlled by your DNA from your past, because you want to be in the moment. You can't be in the moment when your DNA is bringing you into the past. Do you all understand that? Okay. So the whole thing is to get into the now timeline where nothing is activated. All your activations, and the worst thing you ever want to have is DNA activations. Holy shit, what's going to happen to you? Man, you're going to get all this alien stuff coming into you. I'm sure that the New Agers or the, you know, practitioners or somebody's touching you, giving you energy, you know, or, you know, there's much more to it than that, but you want to get out of this system. You want to get out of the DNA controlling stuff. You want to be in the now. So what didn't I cover? Yes?
Barcode.
Great. Okay, here we go. So let's take off a barcode on you that maybe is giving you poor health. Okay? That seems to be, you know, right? So here we go. Ready? So you could have more than one. So let's take off the first one. So first one, released. And just see if your energy changes in your body. You may have 10 of these because people die from poor health, right? Next one. Released. Next one, released. Number four, released. Five, released. Six, released. Seven, eight, nine, and 10. How is your body feeling? Yeah, okay, when you go out to this room and this thing ends, I want you all to look at the people around you, because they're going to be one of those cloned bodies. Remember, there's two different types of clones, right? There's the ones that are cloned 100% continuous, right? Then you have the ones that switch out every 10 minutes. So you're going to be seeing both, but they're not going to be human. They're not going to have that spark of energy in them like you have right now. Yes?
Yeah, Ron, I'm probably not the only one that's had this happen. When I was about 10, I didn't remember being taken.
Yeah, everybody's been abducted.
I do remember when they put me back, and either they give you something to put you to sleep, but
yeah.
Right when they put me back, and it was like a gray, it scared the crap out of me naturally at that age.
Let me take away that experience. Ready?
Why did they do that?
Oh, they're playing with everybody. They're experimenting, taking your DNA, taking your blood samples, everything else, making clones. Remember, you could be yourself on other alien planets, other planets you don't even know about out there. The universe is very big, right?
Right.
And they could have wanted a piece of you in the beyondo.
Gotcha.
So I'll take away that experience. Ready? Everybody have an experience where it kind of frightened them?
Yes.
You know, it could be an alien one. It could be anything. Ready? Here we go. I'll take it away. I'll count to 10 to do it slow for you. You can actually feel it leave you, okay? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There. So it should be pretty much numbed out in you.
Remember, take away a bad experience, though?
If it's tying you into the past, of course.
Right, but I mean, I like to feel like, I try and learn from my bad experiences.
Oh, that's the first problem. You don't want to learn from your experiences. No, you're not here to learn. You're here to be in the moment. You're learning, that means you got to keep learning. That's the never-ending story. You know, people say, didn't I come here because I wanted to learn more? Well, yeah, in the light of darkness, of course. They popped you back down here again, gave you another body, cleaned your spirit out because it was all screwed up and contaminated because it died, and you died. You know, your body died. It has the same thing as you. You had cancer, you had this, you had that. You got hit by a train or whatever. it's messed up. It gets dusted off, put back together again, and then you get slammed dunked into a body. You have free choice at that point what they give you. So you pick the best of the worst parents, you know, and you're probably in your soul family, and you get dumped back down here again as a baby, brand new, glowing of light, and then you start learning how to live here again, and you wonder why you're here. But you're not here to learn anything. You're here to be in the moment, to experience, okay? I should probably do some more healing. So what kind of healing can I do for you? How much time do we have left? I know time is getting short. Yes.
4 minutes.
I have a thyroid thing. I just feel like it's something that's some weird thing because, you know, they want to tie you into the medication, especially with the whole thyroid thing. So.
Yeah. Come to my booth and I can show you different clearings to do. Remember, all I can do for you is take away your gunk. Okay? Source energy takes away stuff to bring you more of source energy back, which is your spirit. Understand that? I can't do any attunements on you. I'll be bringing in stuff that you can't hold. You know, how do you get more water in a glass when it's filled up? You can't. You got to get rid of the old programs to allow space for your spirit to come back into your body. And then you're back into more source energy. You can't get more of your spirit energy than you had when you were born. That's all that you have in each lifetime. In each lifetime, it diminishes. Why? Because you went to church and you prayed to Jesus. You got the lights, you know, the darkness energy attached to you. Whatever it would be that you went to. Did attunements. You had somebody do some energy work on you. They did some whatever it was. You got hooked into more darkness, which stole more of your spirit energy from you. Yeah, it felt great.
1 minute.
Water charging. Everybody have water? So like I said, I can't change your belief system. Your belief system has worked for you perfectly for your whole life. Hardest thing to do is to convince people. All I can show you is to be in your heart center. Then you may catch on to something. And we'll just wait for them to come back here. On my website, I have a clearing that's free. It's a 2,000 Year of Darkness barcode. They stuck that on you, so at this time of ascension, you're going to be going to all the woo-woo stuff from the 1970s on to get you so you can't do ascension because now you're stuck into more of these spiritual practices. Do that clearing. It'll help you out a whole bunch. And if you have any friends, do it on them too. It's a free clearing. So let's wait a little bit here for her to come back. They're out getting water. What's that?
Can we bring it to your booth?
Yeah, my booth number is, yeah, you can bring it there too. My booth number is, yeah. What's that?
We're mostly made of water.
Yeah, it'll affect your body too.
Booth number 204.
Yeah, 204 is my booth. So here we go. Do some water charging. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, we'll do it again here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So this water will be compatible to your body. It'll give you what you need. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There it is. So have some water and just see how it tastes. Normally it'll taste different. It'll go in your mouth and your body will want it. So normally when you drink water, you don't know what's in that water. You know you have to have something that looks like water, right? Because you're thirsty. So you can sample this yourself, okay? Pour yourself some water, and you know you need to have water, but you put it into your mouth, and if you can sample that half a second, your body's going, oh, crap, what do they give me? Well, I got to drink it, so I'm going to swallow it, right? But this water here, there's no question. It goes right on down. And I have a water activation on the website, I think, for $1 if you want to charge your water up. And it gives you what you need at that moment. Remember, the source only works in the moment. You have to remember that. No timelines. It's in the moment. And that's what you need. Yes?
Where do you live?
I live in Mount Shasta, but I don't work. I have everything's on my website, so I don't see people. Okay? Just go in. I have lots of clearings. And check out the free ones for sure. I have radio programs. I probably have about 1,000 archives trying to help people out so they can understand a little bit. And we'll be handing out, if you want to come to the my booth, I think we have some DVDs we can hand out to people. And she has some there. So if you're interested in a DVD, do we have a lot of them with us? Or okay. What's on the DVD is one of my radio programs on Contact Talk Radio. And there's, what, about 43 programs on it. They're basically an hour long. And we talk about different issues to kind of help people out. And it's very, very well organized. And the BBS ones that I have, about 1,000 archives, they kind of go kind of all over the map, what people ask and stuff. So this year is a little more condensed to help you out, to try to help you. Oh, that's great. That's great. Okay, so let's. I want to do healing, so I need to know what you want me to help you out with.
The spine.
Spine?
Yeah, I would love to have, I mean, the spine is kind of like very...
Okay, okay, it's spine. Why don't you all stand up, we'll work on your spine. Okay, so here we go. Spine energy. So we'll start off... I'll divide you into four sections, starting from the bottom up. So we'll go one-fourth of the way up. So here, just run some energy here. I'll count to 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Okay, now we'll go from that point up halfway up your spine. You might feel some energy moving. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Next part. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, and all the way up now, the last part, last quarter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. There, how does your back feel? Feel better? Okay. Next, throat, thyroid, is that what people want? Thyroid? Okay, here we go. So I'm going to first take away alien critters, okay, parasitic life forms that are attached to that. So here we go. Get these released here. There, you feel a little bit lighter there, feel better. Remember you're a host, okay? Remember all your spiritual practices brought these things in. Okay, there we go. And now we're going to bring in some source energy in your spirit. So here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There, that feel better? Feel better, okay. What's next? Neck? What do you have?
Adrenals?
Yeah. Okay, so we'll do the left area. Okay, so we'll just say left kidney, adrenals. Okay, ready? So 1, 2, 3. Getting rid of alien critters. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. Okay, and run some source energy there, your spirit energy. What I'm doing is enhancing your spirit because your spirit's wounded. So I'm charging up your spirit with source energy to help you. Okay, that's all I can do. Okay, I always work through your spirit. I'm not going to give you anything else but that. There we go. There. How's that adrenal feel? Okay, other side. This would be your left side. I mean right side. Okay, here we go. So taking away alien critters, parasitic life forms. There we go. There. More source energy coming to you. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There. What's next?
Heart.
Circulatory? Okay, I'll give you some amber blood. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There. They start to feel your body surge. Okay, what's next?
Eyes.
All right, so here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. The light chamber works great for the eyes. If you haven't been in the light chamber, get in there.
Light chamber?
Yeah, I have a light chamber here. And you want to do 5 sessions, and it costs $40, okay? The first one cleans off your auric field, and the other 4 imprint you with light codes, which aliens took out of you. You feel wonderful afterwards. Working with eyes. That's all I can do for eyes there, okay?
Do you see when you're moving, removing all this stuff?
Yeah, if I... Yeah, if I want to see it, I can see it, yeah. Yeah. If you saw what I saw, you wouldn't want to see what I see. But, you know. Oh, okay, I want to take out an energy, a snake energy. It's out of your stomach area. Okay, here we go. So these are alien critters that live in you, right? This shouldn't sound so weird. You know, what did we have before we had the microscope and somebody talked about some kind of virus or something, or right? Not now that you can see it, right? Well, I'm just pulling out stuff that they don't have a microscope for yet. But people do see these things. Here we go, coming out, coming out. There we go, almost out, out, there. How's that feel?
Good.
Reproductive system?
Yeah,
okay, here we go. There we go. Get rid of some alien critters here. Huh? There we go. A little more coming out. There. Source energy coming in. This I can call a spirit infusion. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There. What next?
Brain.
Okay. What I'll do is work on your, you have a little membrane between your left and right hemisphere. Right? I'll work on that for you to have better communication. So here we go. Taking away what you have going on there. There we go. There, let's then spirit infusion. There we go. There. Joints? Ah, joint lubrication. Okay, here we go. Ready? Anybody have any problems? You know, okay. So focus on it right now. Maybe you just have one or two problems. Maybe you have a lot more, but here we go. Taking away the critters that are stuck there. These look like little caterpillars. Alien caterpillars, we'll say, and they kind of like poke into you, giving you inflammation, okay? And I'm sure all of you are going to be able to go and talk to your husband or wife, you know, and your neighbor about what you had today here, or the next person you see on a booth. You know, and don't get touched by people, you know. If you can avoid being touched, because you have a lot of light now, what does the darkness want to steal from you? So if you do have a session with a massage practitioner or something, cancel it. No, I'm serious, because they're going to give you all the crud back again. Okay? You understand that?
How long will you avoid contact?
Well, you can't. You can shrink wrap. You can command your body to take your auric field and put it right to your skin so you're not having energy outside of your body where people are walking in and out of it. 2 minutes left?
Yeah.
Okay?
Can you do that now?
Yeah, do it. Command your body to shrink wrap. Well, here, I'll show you what it's like. Ready?
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to take your energy field, and it won't connect to anybody else, but I'll bring it up to the wall here. Ready? Zip, now it's to the wall. How do you feel? Like you're exposed? Okay. So a lot of people have your energies about maybe 6 feet out, because you want to see if it's safe for you. But you don't want to do that, because you're going to be getting all the crud. I'll put it right to your body. Zip, there. Now you're right on your body. Yeah, okay, there's emotional bodies too, and there are people that want to take your energy, yes. Yeah, this could help you, but I have clearings on the website to help eliminate this stuff. So you can come and see me at my booth.
What is the name of the number?
Booth number is 204. It's a light chamber. You see a big silver light chamber. I have four monitors for healing. You come in and just put the monitors on. It's free, the headphones, and you can have some sample clearings. Okay,
how
yes.
Pineal calcification or any other pineal issues?
Yeah, okay, here we go. Pineal gland, so here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And again, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. There. Okay, how do you people feel? And if you need more information, I am doing a Monday. If you can come Monday, I'm doing a event at, I think, 6 o'clock. It's kind of a time that maybe it's hard to get people because you're working, but and that I do have another lecture tomorrow here.
Can you say one thing about heavy metals in the body?
Heavy metals? That's a little more complicated. I can do a quick one here. Take away heavy metals here. You might feel it inside of your mouth. So one, getting it out. Two, can't get all of it out, but I can help you. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, and 10. There. How's that feel?
I taste that.
You can taste it? Yeah. Again, one, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, and 10. There. So, if you have any questions, I'll be at my booth. You can ask me, you know, hopefully this is enjoyable for you. Okay? Thank you.